Hello everybody, my name is Tucker, and welcome back to our Russian Fishing 4 Float Fishing Character. Today, I'm a bit exhausted, so I decided to come back to Winding Rivulet. Saw a zebra mussel spot, there's also a crayfish spot not too far away, so hoping to get at least one of those two. So, on the two bottom rods, I've got size 22 hooks with, what do I have on there? I've got algae on them. They both have a clip of 9. Down here at 118, 124, not too far from the geek campsite, just right back there. So, on this rod, bolo rod, I've got casters, and I think I put actually a pretty big hook on. I think I put a 10 hook on, so we'll see what this rod does, if anything, down here. I think it actually just got caught on the tree there. And we'll see what we can do today. Started off with that small zebra right as I started up. That one didn't even ring the bells on the bottom rod. I was casting this rod out and happened to look over and see the line go slack. It's a warm day, high 80s, low 90s. Today, and I had to mow the grass somewhat unexpectedly. Supposed to get some good rain tomorrow, and I didn't realize that, so I had to go out in the heat of the day and mow the grass, so I'm pretty worn out. I kind of didn't want to think too much. Open with this rod to get dace or nace, possibly chubs. Come on, fishy fish. Yes, come on, muscle. Muscly muscle. The brain ain't all there today. We are kind of in the bend here. So I was curious, did not mean to click. I was curious what the float's going to do. Nice gudgeon there. Chat's having fun with that one. My own fish. Didn't expect it to be this slow, not gonna lie. A little deeper. Curious what Dace and Ace have been biting off of. I'm going off my previous knowledge. Yeah, they've all been on casters. Dace, let's look at Ace real quick. Interesting. Ace over on Octuba. River muscle meat too. Wow. Piece of the hamburger I had for dinner stuck in my teeth back in the back molars area. Got it freed up. Fish. In minutes, one small fish. Can't even hide this because it's already 8:30 tonight. Wanted to go somewhere else. I don't have time. Polo's obviously not going to work. Hook off. See what a bloodworm gets. I think if it's nibbling or if it's too deep, dragging along the bottom there. Both are possible. I think this is that. Yeah, it is that 1 meter. dragon on the bottom. So 2.75 and fish. Fish. Even smaller zebra. It's shallower over there, good to know. Glad we at least got two zebra mussels, even if they're worthless. I'm not saying we already have mussel trip. Yet neither. Post I saw had four trophies in it. Two zebra mussels and two river mussels. In under an hour, right here. Four-legged things, all kinds of worn out too. At the end of the street today again for about 10 minutes. And got to chase off the lawnmower. And got to go for RID in the TRUCK. He's had a busy day too. Boy. And got a hamburger for dinner too, because I dropped a hamburger I was grilling on the patio. Right after I mowed the grass. A frozen patty, so. Picked it up, tossed it on the grill for him. Grabbed a fresh one for me. Fishy fish. My voice is tired. Let's try. Button. Let's try flies in very shallow. See if we can at least catch something here. Small days. Another trophy gadget. Oh, come on. Not happy about that one. There's a bleaker, small one though. Fishy fish. This spot has upset me. I'm gonna move just a little bit over, especially for nighttime. We'll see if we can't get a crayfish. I'm looking for 111. I think that's right over here. One of these out. This one I'll put a size 20. a non-open can of soda that I almost just knocked off the couch. That's three, Tucker. White eye. This chub that you see in chat are probably from spin fishing. A good spin fish spot too. Small bream. I can cut up just barely. Hey, another fish piece. Marker bream. I was too late. So that's two missed fish, neither one of which was qualified as a fish got away. Got whatever this is. Small bleak. Tiny, worthless. I missed that one. Perch, I think. Yep. Small worthless perch. Another small bream. First crayfish I've seen in chat. Not thinking straight. This, put a red worm on. Go deeper. Try a meter here. Ooh, big fish. perch. 473 gram perch on the ultralight, 69.7 on the float fishing percentages. Level, whatever you want to call it. Probably a bream species. Nice white eye bream. Reason I said it was a bream species before I even pulled it out, it was just the way it pushed the float up instead of pulled it down like this fish did. Weekly record ultralight white bream, white eye bream, and weekly record telestick bream. That wasn't even a trophy either. And it's Saturday evening, so that may stick up in the US. Was just a regional, but I'll take that. Gibble. At least this spot's been a little more alive. Might be bait choice because I am using red worm. Don't think there's actually a fish on 3. Worth at least picking it up. move the tower fan that I have in front of my legs and blowing up my shorts. Feels real weird, but real good at the same time. How hot it was today. Probably a little TMI there, but it was a warm day. Kind of glad I have that running. Even with the AC on, warm in here. I've got metal siding on my house, so my house tends to stay warm. Worthless tiny Bream. And my house is broadside, east-west. So it gets a lot of sun during the day. And my neighbor across the street cut down their big tree that blocks a lot of sun last year, so they get tired of cleaning up a which I get, but they tell me they plan on planting something else sooner or later. Unmarker bream that will cut up. That looked like a crayfish. It was. But it was a small one. All worthless bream. There's a crayfish. Here, crayfish are, especially in the southern United States, they'll be crawfish. Oh. What do we have here? Chub? It was almost the limit of this line. Curious what that white bream is. But I number one by far on Telestick. That will definitely stick in the US. Look to see what their regional ones are. Curious now. 646 grams. another non-marked bream that we'll cut up at the end here. Yeah, dog pod. The face. Nice rough. I don't know if that dog sigh came through or not, but I'm getting comfy upside down. Nor. A little bit upset with the fan blowing in his ear. That white eye got me excited, and now nothing. Another bream, another white eye though. Nope, normal bream. Someone just looked at the fan that's not moving, trying to figure out why it just suddenly blew in his ear when he moved his head. Little bream. Worthless bream. Curious, do we even need the bream trophy here? trophy number 50. I had to make sure I was actually correct. Name of the day that I've seen so far. I don't know what I saw. And I saw a float drop. Oh, it's the camera's getting some reflection of the rod. That it was the float dropping. Another fish piece, Bream. I think I just messed up a bite there. Trying to tighten it up. Was it interesting? I don't know what it is. Crayfish. Just with the way it took off was just different than anything else we caught. First crayfish float. First crayfish on float. Perch. Not even a good one. Marker off. Marker crayfish on float. I'm going to aim more towards a tree here. Kind of surprised. I was about to say, I'm kind of surprised I caught a marker crayfish on float right as weekly records for both the two crayfish we caught on float show up. One of them wasn't even a marker, and it's a weekly record. That looked like a nice river mussel. It was a river mussel. I used an inappropriate adjective, though. Hide. Same difference. Mainly because it was small. There was definitely a fish on here. Set. Couple more casts here, and it'll be in an hour. It is 9:15, so I gotta get this uploaded here shortly. Luckily, it doesn't take me too long to upload videos. I've got fiber internet. Get them uploaded pretty quick. I think this might be the last fish. Yep, and we'll call it on that marker. I'd rather call it on a decent fish than just cast and get nothing. Not the best day. Oh, I heard the jingle as I was picking it up. I'd already pressed the button, though. Oh, well. Not the best day. We did get the record white-eye bream for both ultralight and telestick. And then we got two record telestick, and we haven't looked at this one yet. Telestick and ultralight freshwater crayfish, just because those are rare. Rare enough that a regional record for the week is not even a marker. Thirty-four fish. I don't think it's going to be a good day, silver-wise or XP-wise, honestly. Hoping to get to 23 next week, and then may do the Norwegian Sea, this character, to try and get to 24. Sell the worthless river mussel for 4. Not get a 49 gram zebra mussel. Not get 2 404 gram white eyes. Nothing else. Yeah, nothing else. 4 silver plus 22, 26, 27 silver. Not the best. White eye was the best fish we got. Parker crayfish wasn't too bad. I knew it wasn't going to be an expensive day. And all of the bait we used was pretty much just dug bait, so I'm okay with that. So let's take a quick look at the, and I just screwed it up again, Telestick Weekly US. There have been literally 2 freshwater crayfish caught on float in the US. No wonder the 2 I caught were weekly records. In the world, they've been caught pretty well. And if we look at ultralight, probably going to be the same thing. Yep. Same thing. So is what it is there. Got number 1 weekly record crayfish and white eye bream, but not going to really do anything for us there. So hope you all enjoyed. We'll be back on the spin fishing character tomorrow, and we'll see you then. Bye bye now.